Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745 is unique because it's different from the other probiotics that are mainly bacteria. It's unique by the wall composition, by its resistance to antibiotics, and by some clinical characteristics that are very important to distinguish. With bacterial probiotics, there is a risk, an important risk, that is the inactivation of the bacterial probiotic by the antibiotic because it can be susceptible. Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745 was studied in almost 18 different diseases, and it was used by almost 500 million people since its first release in 1953. Now, the main indications are antibiotic-associated diarrhea, relapsing Clostridium difficile diarrhea, acute gastroenteritis, and Helicobacter pylori infection that is a very epidemic infection in all the world, mainly in the developing world. We have many evidence, mainly for Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745. In the case of antibiotic-associated diarrhea, there are two main papers, one published by Sajewska and the other by Goldenberg, both in 2015. The paper from Goldenberg is a Cochrane collaboration publication that is maybe the best standard of quality of a publication. And they both show that using Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745, we can reduce the incidence of antibiotic-associated diarrhea. In the case of Clostridium difficile infection, that is a special kind of antibiotic-associated diarrhea, we also have important evidence. We will mention again Goldenberg's publication, but this one from 2017, in which in a new Cochrane collaboration publication, he shows that using Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745, you can reduce the risk of Clostridium difficile infection. Infectious acute diarrhea is unfortunately a disease that is very common in all the world. In this disease, the probiotics are also useful, especially Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745 has been shown as very useful by a publication from Dinleci from Turkey in 2012. Other publications that are important is the Maastricht Consensus, published in GATT in 2016 by Malferheiner from Germany and co-workers, in which they recommend the use of Saccharomyces boulardii mainly to reduce the risk of side effects. Also, important guidelines in adults, the one by the World Gastroenterology Organization, published in 2017, and the main author was Francisco Warner from Barcelona, Spain, and also the ESPGAN, that is the guidelines for pediatrics doctors, in which they recommend also the use of Saccharomyces boulardii CNCMI745, mainly to reduce the risk of side effects.